leads it up the wing. Brock Besser into the zone. Hits the brakes. Besser back to the line. Elias Lindholm, a shot swallowed up. Skating after the puck, Sam Lafferty. Trying to dig it out behind the Calgary net. Kept into the point, hit the side.
It was vicious.
Now across the line, Hoglander for Vancouver. Plays it back to the point for Hughes. Whips it across to Hronek. And that one got through and kicked out by Markstrom.
He's really happy with what he has down the middle in his lineup.
At the line, here's Uyghur for Calgary. And it floats in on Demko. Steers it aside. Takes the hit from Uyghur. Down low for Hoglander in the corner. Pivots away from Miramanov. Hronek looking for a tip in front. And that's turned aside by Markstrom.
They want him to bring a more physical brand of hockey. He's worked on it and has listened to the message and has done a good job with the Wranglers.
Hoglander in front, driving the net, McKayev.
The Flames have really struggled with the pressure that the Canucks have put in their zone, but just watch the smart play by McKayev. He gets in behind the coverage, and Hoglander just puts his puck into space, and McKayev on his back end.
But everything else still undetermined for the most part in the Western Conference. In front, and a shot in close, and Markstrom right there to make the save.
Man, again, another time where Markstrom gets really deep in his net. You see Suter putting some screen pressure in front, but because it comes from the corner, he has to stay deep in his net, and I think that allows him to actually make.
Flames have scored a power play goal in 8 of the last 9 games. In fact, the last 9 games, Calgary at 42%. On the power play, Kuzmenko hits the bar. Demko plays it behind his own net, high off the glass. Whacked out by Lindholm, and here comes the Canucks. Teddy Bluger rink wide. Myers driving the net, shorthanded.
Well, this is just a poor job by the Calgary Flames, just not recognizing. You see Backlund comes over to one side. You've got the defenseman over to that side as well, Miromanov, and they don't even recognize Myers, the defenseman for the Vancouver Canucks, streaking up the right side, and he has all day to pick his spot.
On Saturday night, a 3-1 win for Vancouver, and keep in mind, McDavid did not play in that game for Edmonton. Moving up, McKayev, former Maple Leaf, sends it rink wide. Shot, score!
And the east-west passes. It's led by Pettersson out of his zone, but watch how many passes are allowed to go cross ice. The first one here by McKayev, and then the last one that goes from Pettersson back to Hoglander, and it's in the back of the net. The east-west passes are just a killer to defend and impossible for a goaltender to stop the opportunities.
And Zadorov nearly found that corner as Markstrom was guessing wrong. But luckily he went wide. Huberdeau moving in. Huberdeau pass across.
Played so well for the Flames this year. Been a real consistent player for them.
Kadri ahead. Pospisil drops it for Kadri. Driving the net. Kadri! And a save by Demko.
You know, and just so serious on game day, just so detailed. And, you know, really, I think, you know, when he was healthy, and especially early in the season, one of the top 5 goaltenders for sure in the league.
Joshua scores! 2-on-1, and Dakota Joshua makes it 3-0 Canucks.
You know, this line had such a good night the other night against Edmonton. And if this line can get going on the offensive side of things, they can be a shutdown line. They can be an offensive line. And what a shot here by Joshua. The entire way up the ice, he's looking off as if he's going to pass it over. And he just buries it again, blocker side on Jacob Markstrom.
Rick wide. Miramanov, and a shot turned aside by Demko. Miramanov creeping in, sends it down low, pass across. Pospisil point blank chance. Another save by Demko, lost his stick.
Watch the movement of Demko. He stretches across to his right, loses his stick in the process, but nice movement to make a great save there on Pospisil.
Headband and tipped ahead by Pospisil, a race for the puck. as Calgary jumping the lines, tipped in front by Adam Clapkin, another save by Demko.
I'm always amazed how quickly they have to make decisions, right? Have all the rules in their head and make split-second decisions. It's incredible.
Huberdeau in front for Kadri, and leaning and making the save is Demko.
And this is another save where you're going to see Thatcher Demko's movement as the Flames go. They change the point of attack. Kuzmenko to Huberdeau. He has to come across and then come out and get enough of the angle to make the save on Kadri.
Shillington, a shot that gets blocked. Shillington again fakes the slapper. Kadri, a redirection in front by Kuzmenko and a kick save by Demko. The stick of Mangiapane tips it out to center. Hughes in a turnover. Mangiapane into the zone. Hits the break, spins, moves in. Slap shot, squeezes through, and a save as Demko got a piece of it, kicked out by Quinn Hughes. When I look at the numbers, Cassie, and here's one more look at the save by Hughes, and it went through the five-hole of Demko, and that's how close it was for Calgary.
It was literally sitting on the goal line. Like, just watch this. It just sits there, and luckily Hughes doesn't actually...
Kadri from Miramanov driving the slot, and the pass behind him, and here comes a three-on-two back the other way. Hoglander a backhand. Joshua, save Markstrom. It's funny, U.S.-born players, that two of the top three... scorers in the NHL for U.S.-born players play for the Canucks. Pahal moves in, shot, score! The Flames are on the board. It's 3-1, Vancouver.
Second goal on the season for Pahal. Just a good job on the forecheck as Soucy's unable to get the puck out, then loses his stick, which means he loses a little bit of position, and you can see all kinds of traffic there in front that Demko had to deal with. It doesn't hit anything, but you can tell his movements. He really doesn't see this at all until it's behind him.
So the former Golden Knight, Braden Pahal. Zadorov leaves it for Myers in a turnover. Shot, save Demko. Miramanov a shot and a second opportunity off the rebound. 5:10 to go. 3-1 Vancouver, 3-0 lead until Braden Pahal scored here in the third. Two first period goals by the Canucks. Minute 28 apart. Kadri went down. Miller driving. Strike up the Simple Minds.
I mean, JT Miller gets this puck on a turnover right here by Kadri. A nice little stick play there by Pettersson. And just, you know, a couple strides and boom, hits this box in the back of the net. You know, just head up the whole way, not looking to deep, just, I'm going to take my shot.
Could lead to a three-on-two, back the other way. Here comes Hughes. Hughes driving the net, shot save, and a good kick save by Markstrom. Power play for Vancouver, they're 0-for-1 tonight. Hughes plays it over to Miller. Off the bank behind, and not much on. The redirection by Garland nearly generated goal number five.
So you don't think this matters, you know, Rick Tocchet, just to coach like you're going to coach in the playoffs.
Stretch pass, Hughes to Miller, shot save with a glove by Markstrom and a clear for Calgary. Besser, backdoor for Miller, couldn't handle the pass, and the final seconds will tick off. And for the first time in 11 years, the Vancouver Canucks are division champions.